Hello everyone, I'm back, and I'm going to work on the GO table again, but first of all I want to thank Jay and Dolores for supporting my channel. I'm very grateful, and it helps a lot, so thank you so much. So what did I do? I removed the masking tape, and for some people that want to know what kind I'm using a masking tape that I buy at the supplier where I also buy my resin. And the masking tape is heat resistant up to 60 degrees. So I don't have any problems with that it sticks to my resin or MDF board or whatsoever. I can take it off very easy. So that I do first. And after that I sanded the edge, because I had a sharp edge on the top layer of UltraCast. So that needed to come off. And I used a small mechanical tool for it. We call it a Dremel. I don't know how you call it, but it's a small mechanical tool where a little sander is attached onto. And after that I used some waterproof sandpaper, and I used different kinds of grain. I used the 400, 800, 1200 and 2000. Because I had also some parts in the UltraCast layer that I didn't like, so I sanded that also. And after that I cleaned it with alcohol. And yeah, then it was ready to go for the color I'm putting now onto the edge. I'm using the Lumiere Metallic Indigo. And it's almost the same color as I have on the table. And it's a base coat, because I want to do something else to the edge. But I need a base coat. I also want to thank all the people that made such nice suggestions what I can do with the edge. And I'm going to take a couple of suggestions and I mix them together, if you know what I mean. So, not all of them, but a couple of it. So, the whole edge I'm going to paint the metallic indigo. I give it two layers. And then I need to let it dry. Because I want also to use some gold leaf, what some people have used, suggested, not all the way around the edge, but on some places. And yeah, then it needs to dry first before I can apply the gold leaf. So almost done with the edge, and then I can put some gold leaf glue on it and apply the gold leaf. Before I can put the gold leaf on, I need to put some glue. This is a special glue, especially for the gold leaf. I put it in some places, not all the way around, and also a little bit on top. And if I am ready with that, I need to let it dry for 10 minutes, and then you can apply the gold leaf on it, so that it sticks. So in different places I am putting down some glue. All the materials I'm using are in this video and also in the description box below. Also the links where I buy it. So if you want to know, then you need to take a look. So we are 10 minutes later, and now I can apply the gold leaf. The sheet that is on top of the gold leaf is meant that you leave it on top, because otherwise you damage the gold leaf. So yeah, very carefully I'm putting it down, because it's very thin, the gold leaf. And it sticks only on the places where I applied the gold leaf glue. Very carefully I press it with my fingers, not too hard. And in this video I'm only working on the outer edge. And in the next video I'm going to work on the on the holes, because I want to put some crystals there and some stones, and yeah, that takes a lot of time. So in this video only the outside. So first, where I put the glue on, I apply the gold leaf. Almost done. And with a brush you can brush the excess of the gold leaf away. And where you don't have the glue, you brush the gold leaf from the table. Yeah, so you can see I speeded this video a little bit, because otherwise we have a very long video. And there you can also see that I didn't apply the glue on the whole edge, only in some spots. And the excess you can use again. I save it in a cup. And yeah, you can use it for other projects. So almost done, and then I'm going to the next step. Because I'm not done with the edge yet. Yes, and now I'm going to apply some glitter, and I'm using diamond glaze. That's a glue I also use for making my jewelry, and it's a very nice glue. It dries clear, so you don't see it anymore. And the glitter I'm using is a mixture of dark blue and the Cosmic Shimmer Holographic Glitter Blitz, the Midnight Marine. And I mixed that together. And I wanted to give it a little bit of a luxury look to it. That's why I'm applying the glitter. And it sparkles, and I like that also. And the excess of the glitter that's on the plastic underneath, you can use again. So you don't have to throw it away. So a line of glue on the side, and with a brush I spread it out. Also in between the gold leaf. Yeah, and then with my fingers I put it on. And it's very messy, but yeah, it doesn't matter. You can clean it again. And I like this. And this glue dries within an hour. So I find it very fast. And again, I'm putting it with my fingers on the glue. It doesn't have to be a thick layer, only a thin layer. And it sparkles, so that's nice. And with a brush, I brush the glitter that it's on top away. But yeah, when I'm done and the glue is dry, then I need to clean it the top again with some alcohol. And I'm also also using some mica flakes, and I mixed some gold glitter, also the Cosmic Shimmer Sahara Gold, into it. And at the end of the video, I have a video from up close, so then you can see it. But it are very nice mica flakes. So again, I'm brushing the glitter away that I have on top. So almost done, and then we go to the close-up. So this is up close, and I couldn't take it outside because the glue wasn't dry yet. But okay, we can do it also inside. So you can see there the gold leaf, and in between I have the mixture of glitter. It's also holographic, very nice. Also the gold leaf a little bit on top. And I find that it looks luxury, and yeah, I like it. all the way around. It sparkles a lot. And there you see that I sanded the edge, but if I give it a top coat of UltraCast, you don't see it anymore. And there you see the mica flakes with the gold glitter mixed in it. So in the next video, I'm going to work on the inside of the holes, and I'm going to apply some crystal, some crystals, and some other things that I like. And yeah, that takes also some time to add. So yeah, you need to wait for that video. So if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up if you like what I'm doing, and don't forget to click the little bell, because then you get all the notifications of my channel. And if you have comments or tips, please place them under the video. You can also find me on Facebook under Just Paint. And there you can also see my jewelry that I make. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye!